Good morning. It is day three here in Portugal. I literally just woke up, took a shower like 5 minutes ago. What are we doing today, babe?
Obidos, I think.
What?
Or something in Fatima. And then maybe we'll go to the park later.
Yeah, so that. So we're gonna go down head for breakfast soon. So you guys see what the breakfast buffet is like. Fuck, can't even talk any coffee. Alright, yeah, let's go head down. I would have liked to show you breakfast, but there's too many fucking people. So I'll show you tomorrow. Okay, bye.
I don't know.
Can you please explain where we're at?
We are in Fatima.
Fatima?
The sanctuary. We're going to the sanctuary.
Yeah, but where are we at
they,
right now? This is a store.
This is a store.
The first place they brought us to is a store.
Yeah, because you need to pee. It was like an hour and a half drive.
That's true. I fell asleep, bro.
Me too. I was like, my head was,
and then,
my head,
oh shit, did you sit in
there? Back and forth. Nope.
And then, you know, I wanted to show the store, but you can't use photography or video, so F.
You are in a holy place.
This is not
holy.
No,
Mama Mary's inside.
Okay. But I'm not inside right now.
Flash for this.
You see what I mean, bro? I'm not inside right now. I'm outside. So what else do you think?
What? Think about what?
The store. Did you buy a lot of things?
There's a lot of nice things in there.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I mean, you obviously bought that.
Just don't show it. I think I'm the only one who bought stuff.
Probably.
I'm always the only one.
She literally, like everywhere we go, she's literally the only one buying shit. I'm not lying.
Not true.
I'm not lying. Literally. What is this place? Deb? We're in the sanctuary of Fatima. Fatima or Fatima? See it?
Okay, so point out some directions around here, okay? So that tree over there, okay, was where the children were and where they would wait for the apparitions, okay? And when the first apparition took place. And the apparitions took place right there, and you have that chapel. It's right there, inside that structure. That's the apparitions chapel.
Wow.
Okay. Behind that, you have the place where you burn candles.
Okay.
The candles could be in a lot of shapes: legs, arms, buns. Okay. Depends on the problem that you're struggling with. So, if you have a leg problem, you come here,
yes.
Buy a candle in the shape of a leg, you make a prayer
and you burn it.
And you burn it, and by faith, you'll get better. Okay. On the other end of the sanctuary, you have this new basilica, inaugurated in 2008, okay? And you have this white path, people start walking on their knees on the far end, and they come around the apparition chapel, okay? So that basilica, that church was inaugurated in 2008. The sanctuary here was in the 60s. Inside, you have the tombs of the three shepherds, okay, two that died really young age, and Sister Lucia, okay, you can visit inside, okay. On that side, in the middle of those trees in this direction, yes. Looks like a wall. You have actually part of the Berlin Wall, okay, that was a gift by Portuguese, symbolizing that second revelation, that second secret of Fatima, okay. Here in the middle, you have a statue of the Holy Heart of Jesus. Okay. And around the statue, you have some fountains with holy water. Okay?
Okay. So they just gave you, our tour guide just gave you the rundown of where we are at. We're just going to go towards where the apparitions were. Okay? Let's just go there.
I'll apologize because, she's the one.
Some candles to burn?
Yeah. We're just gonna get regular ones because they said it comes in different shapes and forms depending on what your intention is. If your hand is hurting or something, then you get a hand. Yeah. So we'll just get normal. We'll get one for our friends and one for family.
What are the big ones? You should get the monster ones, dude.
Where?
So monster candles. Found her. She's too slow.
It's 56. Where do we put them?
Give it to that guy. Oh, here, babe. No. See this? This is where you get it. Right here, babe.
To signify the second secret That was told by the Blessed Virgin, I think. About water or something?
Sure. Hey. Hey. Got it. Okay. All right, where are we heading?
To the Basilica. It's newer.
So the newer Basilica. Right?
Yeah. Ooh, jump on a second. This is for Kuya.
There's the entrance. Don Juan takes the crown, he becomes the right hand of the king, okay, and he easily, or he could ask for anything from the king that gladly the king would give to him, okay, but he only asked for a construction of a convent, which is in Lisbon, the Carmo convent. Now it's in ruins, it's in Chiado, okay, and after that he spends the rest of his life as a monk, okay, so that's Nuno Alves Pereira.
But it was, the church was built because this guy prayed to Mama Mary to save him, someone save him, and then there's like a light, and it was like Mama Mary who saved him. Oh. So he built the church, and then that's the Our Lady of Nazareth.
What she said.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
It's the place of this women with seven skirts or something waiting for their fishermen husbands at the shore, something like that.
Yeah, exactly.
All right.
Jeez. This is the proof, Deb, of the legend. That's the legend.
What? What's the legend?
This thing? Okay, cool. Okay, you have a sentence. You have a sentence written in Portuguese over there.
Uh-huh.
It says that aqui não. Antes e depois da sua primeira viagem à Índia, Vasco da Gama veio aqui e rezou à Nossa Senhora da Nazaré. Okay?
And what does that say?
Right.
What does that mean?
Before and
Whoa.
After.
Don't just leave.
You're a very bad boyfriend.
Before and after his first journey to India, oh. Vasco da Gama came here and prayed to Our Lady of Nazareth. Oh. And actually this type of monument, it's a common view in the places that the Portuguese visited during the discoveries, okay? With that cross, which is the cross of the Order of Christ, okay? Of the old Templars, okay? And actually the shield, the Portuguese shield, okay? With the five small shields right there.
So this place was pretty awesome, dude. I mean, this city or town or whatever.
It's so,
right?
Whatever. So calm.
I mean.
Simple.
Yeah, it's just serene over here.
The ladies are retired now, so they just sell dried fruit.
Yeah.
Instead of being the women of the whatever.
Right.
There's a certain look to them, too.
Yeah. I mean, it's cool area. It's just, I mean, it's nice.
Cool. Oh, that's the chapel before the church.
Chapel before the church was built. We just had lunch here at Restaurante Dos Ventos.
It was a pretty good lunch. Now we gotta walk. Now we gotta walk all the way down that way and meet our driver.
Gotta walk all the way down there and hang a left. Somewhere, but we're headed towards the beach. Man, it's really nice here. The weather's. See? What do you think of.
Where are we? Nazare.
Nazare.
What do you think of Nazare?
I just love.
You know what? The seafood here is fucking awesome,
it's
man.
It's really bomb. I don't know. Like, Christopher doesn't eat seafood.
I don't eat
he
seafood.
Eats it here all day long.
It's just so amazing. It's so good here.
It's a very simple town. I love it. It's so calm and friendly.
Right.
It's chilly.
Well, it's because we were inside and.
Oh no! We're by the ocean.
We're by the ocean. We're by the Atlantic. Sorry, it wasn't on me. We're by the Atlantic. So now we're headed back.
Alright, we made it to our spot. We made it to our
destination where we're supposed to meet our driver.
How I know? That guy right there is my landmark. Okay. I mean, this area's pretty cool. Just walking up and down.
Very quaint town.
Very clean town, very crisp air. You know,
you're by the ocean.
This breeze is fantastic.
Yeah.
Women are bountiful. You know, flesh is amongst us. Flesh. Fishermen wives. Didn't want to do that. What I meant to do was.
You know what I mean? Just fishermen wives. You know what I'm saying? I mean, I didn't see any. I'm just
no,
talking.
No, they wear skirts.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, look at that fog behind me. It looks pretty cool, huh? Huh? See that fog behind me, guys? Okay.
Jesus.
Okay,
it's a wild cherry. It is very sour.
Okay.
Very, very sour. And 15 years old after, this is the fruit.
It stays in there for 15 years?
15.
Wow.
It must be good alcohol.
And now we will try with 17 years old.
Okay. Are you driving back? That's what I just need.
No, I'm not gonna have it. It's okay, you can drink. It's okay.
Wow.
Well, it's better for you to taste it, not shot it.
Okay, good. I was going to ask, do we shoot this? Do we shoot this?
Yeah, it's, it, taste it, taste it.
Like pound the table type of thing? Or?
That is cool.
Cool. 17-year-old ginger.
Ginger. Okay, go.
Excuse me.
Thank you.
You're
welcome.
Oh, sorry.
Yes.
No,
I'll have the smallest one.
Okay.
I'll have that little one.
It smells good to you.
Okay.
Give me the biggest one.
Somebody got a leash?
Salud.
Salud.
Cheers, salud.
Salud.
It's good.
This is the original
tea. Oh, I like it.
Oh, it's good.
I don't drink.
Yeah.
I don't drink and I like it.
Yeah.
Is that what this is?
No.
Oh,
I like it.
Yeah, can you put it back?
Can you take those back to the States?
Good. All right, where are we at?
Obidos. Obidos.
Obidos?
It's from a Latin word that means fortified town.
Okay. We are in. You're in a fortified
where
town.
They find the best ginginia.
Where they find the best ginger.
15 to 17 years of age.
The main street right here. This goes all the way to the castle on the other hand.
Okay.
You can go inside the yard of the castle. Okay. You have kind of this street ends on a bookstore to the right side. You have kind of a gate or a path that you go through. You have the yard of the castle. Okay. Well, you can do that, but I also suggest you to do it. Come back or use the small streets, okay? Because the beauty of this village is in the small streets. Here you just have a restaurant, souvenir stores, okay?
Drone footage of the town castle. Now we're just walking around, exploring it. Exploring. Getting lost. Why should fly here? No. Wow, really?
Where are you going on?
Yeah, I can't land here.
It's not even.
You know, she's always one for words, right, guys? That's the theme of this trip.
I think we can go down here.
For all my YouTube subscribers. See those girls over there? They've been at it for the last 15 minutes trying to get the
for my screenshot. 10 YouTube for my 10 YouTube subscribers, which is Emily.
You only get the dirty deets from me on our vacation trips, right, guys?
I bet. Right.
I don't know. Okay, do I look like a tour guide? Do I look like a tour guide? Okay. All right, so just go back.
The same way.
Same way. Don't fall, bro.
trying not to.
See, look at this is some cobblestone shit.
They're
guys,
very slippery.
Guys, this is some cobblestone shit. You cannot walk on this unless you got cleats. You know what I mean? You got cleats? Okay. If you're wearing some rubber shoes, this ain't gonna work out. You know what I mean? Just kidding, guys. Just kidding.
So we're finally back at the hotel. Yeah. We're leaving tomorrow. Today was pretty fun. Did a lot of shit in, what, how many days were we here? 3 days. So, no time wasted. Literally 8 hours a day we were on our feet doing something. More or longer, more than 8 hours. Anyways. Yeah, so this vlog in Portugal was all, well, at least not the first day. First day I wasn't using the gimbal. The rest of the days I was using the gimbal, so I want to see, hopefully the footage was better in terms of stability. We'll see how it goes when I edit this, but till next time, in a month, we'll be going to Greece. Oh yeah. See you in a month.